Hello everyone. It is a wonderful day today and I'm outside in my garden. Anyway, I'm taking on a new project and I would like to share it with y'all. I have been doing a little planting, some herbs, vegetables, and I took on some fruit. So this will be my first time dealing with fruit trees. So yeah, and I'm loving it and I cannot wait to gain fruit. And I would just like to document my journey in the process of me growing some fruit and vegetables. So I'm looking at my phone right now to get a date of when I purchase certain things. So today is February 20th, and February 15th I purchased my second cherry tree, which is Rainier cherries, and then about a couple of months I had bought another cherry tree, which is a Bing.
Camera recording.
Excuse my camera in the front, but anyway, yes, I have purchased months ago from Costco a Bing cherry tree. And the only reason why I purchased a second cherry tree is because I found out that this cherry tree is not a self-pollinator and it definitely needs another tree that is different to help it pollinate. So, anybody out there, a tip I can give you, if you decide to plant a cherry tree, make sure that it can pollinate itself so you will not have to go out there and purchase the second one. Something I was not expecting to do, but I had to since I already had the tree. So I'm gonna go ahead and show y'all what I'm working with, and I think I'm going to do a little pruning. This will be my first time. I've been watching videos and things like
Camera
that,
recording.
trying to get some information since this is my first time being a plant parent. Anyway, so I'm gonna show y'all what I'm working with. So first, have these beautiful mustard greens right here. I need to repot them, but I'm not gonna do it today. Right here is my garlic chives. I haven't tasted yet. This is my first time dealing with that. And then these two right here, I decided to plant strawberries that I have purchased from the store. This is the nectarine tree. We have a little chives, some herbs going on here. This is chives. I need to do some with these because obviously they are growing very slow, and I think it's because I'm not doing something. So I'm gonna look into them. And this is the parsley is growing real good. This is my bell pepper plant, and as you see that it is growing some fruit on the tree. I don't know if you can. This is my cherry tree. I picked up some strawberry plants from Walmart. I don't think this is enough for my family, but we're just gonna, plant them. I don't know if I'm gonna do it today, but then I have my two rosemary plants, and oh my Lord, rosemary smells so good. I love rosemary. I like to cook with it and everything. Today, I am going to be pruning my things, and just throughout videos and vlogs I bring to y'all, I'm going to like show y'all the process of where the plants is at now, especially the trees. I mean, oh my Lord, I just cannot wait to gain fruit because I love cherries. Now, I haven't tasted the Rainierian, whatever. I haven't tasted that yet, but I have tasted Bing, which is a popular cherry. You can pretty much find them at the grocery store or farmer's market. But I'm gonna go right ahead, get my pruning shears out, and get started for today because it's a wonderful day and I wanna make sure I cut these trees short enough.
Oh.
Hello everyone, it's another day, and as you see, I'm just chilling. Today I'm deciding to do the Kimora Hens Deli laptop slash tablet case, and you can even construct it as a craft case, whatever you want. But today I am going to do the laptop case, so I'm hoping it fit in my laptop because I picked the exact size, which is 13 inch. I have a MacBook Pro. I shared with y'all in the last previous video I made of me embroidering a design on the front of the bag. So today I will be putting the bag together. Hopefully I could finish today. I ain't gonna talk too much about it because this pattern is not free. And this is my first time working on this pattern, so new thing for me, so that's fine. But I'm not gonna say too much, give too much information, because this pattern is not free. So I'll just let y'all watch me put it together, and you know, if you decide to purchase the pattern, you can have a video to look back on and to visualize, you know, what pieces go with what. So I'm just gonna let y'all watch me work as I put this bag together. I cannot wait. We're gonna see how this bag come along. So stay tuned for that. I'll see you at my sewing machine. Back, it's another day. Your girl had to take a break, okay? I had a little bit of struggles, and it pretty much be like that. Excuse my dog, but it pretty much be like that when you're dealing with a new pattern and you ain't did it before. But so I'm gonna continue off from where I left off yesterday and finish stitching this bag out. And yes, as you see, I have me some protector glasses so I can protect my eyes, because your girl ain't got time to sit here and be messing up her eyes, okay? You see these eyes? Okay, yes. So I'm gonna continue off where I left off. Probably wondering what's up with that purple. So what happened was I messed up the cutting pattern. You know how you gotta mirror stuff or things like that. I had to literally go back, cut some stuff up. I couldn't find the same fabric I didn't have no more because I had this like my third time cutting this same piece out. So that's how it is. You just learn and you gotta just do what you gotta do. But that's what I'm doing and that ain't stopping me. I'm still going. But like I said yesterday, I literally had to step away and take a break. I'm just lining everything up. I did not even iron this piece. I'm like, uh-uh. I gotta pick my son up in a minute. I'm just getting everything even for me to stitch out around this pocket part, and it's mine, so that's fine. Ain't nobody gonna notice but y'all, so don't tell nobody.
Thank you.
So it's the next day, and I did not finish the bag. I did a lot, but I had looked at the bag and noticed, dang, it's a little plain. I can add another design on a bag, so which I love it. It looks nice. What I did was I went into my Stitch Artist software and played around with it and digitized a design. And so I went to test it out to make sure before I put it on my actual bag, because I did not want it to mess up anything, being that I'm almost finished with it. So I did not record the footage to that, but I will show you before I continue doing the bag. And here we go. I thought this is so cute, and I went on to Joann's and picked this up for the handles. I did want it to do vinyl, but then I first want to see for the first bag how it's going to look. First of all, to make sure you can't see this part, so that way when I stitch it out with vinyl, I can see what I want to do. But I like the design, and I'm gonna just continue where I left off at and see the outcome afterwards. This is a test, and I'm not selling this. I'm making this for myself, and we'll just see the outcome. Thank you. Looking nice. Looking nice.